So in 2010, we had a dream to get 20 members of Camp Catawampus out to Burning Man, and the obvious way to do that, with, well, Gus anyway, was that bus. So we came up with a design for an idea for this bus. The idea was Metropolis. So that was kind of fitting to get there by mass transit. Came up with this design, and the first step was to find a bus, which was pretty easy. It was Craigslist all over Craigslist, and the one we found was actually used by a tip to NASCAR and converted it to RV. So a lot of the major work was done there. So it was converted to RV, but we needed to make it our own. So for over the course of a weekend, we tested all the equipment. As you can see, there was some bunk beds in there. There were tables, seating, lots of other things. But we had to strip it out, get everything out of there, clean it up, and we wanted to, you know, give it a nice pink bath. And look over the end, which I was assumed was done already. But as you can see, it's a little bit worse shape than we had expected. So Tony, our mechanic, you know, did the best he could, worked all weekend, did a pretty good job. Seemed to run pretty good. But we just kept going and taped it up, cleaned it up real good, rewired a lot of the stuff on the inside, tested more equipment. And while I worked on the outside of the paint job, the rest of the members worked on our shade structure that we were going to set up so that we could easily tear down and reassemble the supply. The paint job took pretty much all weekend. A lot of problems that go with that. First off, being I've never painted a bus before. But it went well. So the sunset thing that I was going for seemed to pull off pretty well. And one of the last things we did was build a down deck on the back. So we were able to transport 20 of our bikes, all of our everything, so that we have room on the inside for playing, having a good time. Our finished product. We were very happy with the outcome of this bus. And so, now that we had it, a week later, we got on the road. We drove around, picked up all of our passengers, a couple from out of town. But about Illinois, we started to have some trouble. And it started to get pretty sluggish. But by then, we all kind of, you know, we're just going along with it, and I mean, we ended up at the end of there for a little while as well, and they gave us some pointers. They pointed us in the right direction. As you can see, all the oil in our engine. So we went to a mechanic, and they weren't open yet, so we had to sit here and wait for the next day for them to open. There was really only one option that we had. And that was to keep going. So we bought a new bus. So we found the best one we could, we used all the resources we had, and emptied our bus with all of our equipment, all of our bikes and everything. And we spent the next 6 hours gutting our new bus of all the seats, putting all of our material back in there, and trying to find a space for us to actually sit. We said goodbye to our old bus. It was a very sad goodbye for the musical switch we're here. But we said hello to our new bus. We made the best of it. Lots of games, group meals, Morton's List, and lots of alcohol. About 2,000 miles later, we made it. Here's us at the gates, getting ready to go in. It was an awesome burn. Lots of stories to be told, but that's for another time. This was the last picture we took before we headed on. After the burn, the question was, what are we going to do with the bus afterwards? We couldn't just stay parked. It was a lot of work that we put into it, so we decided to open it up to people if they had any sort of ideas I'd like to do with it, including, you know, getting back and forth to other events, maybe getting back out to Brandon if possible. The first thing that came up was Syncidium. We were able to use it to take it out to Lakes of Fire, get the bees out there, and also various other events they've done things with. The couchsurfing community is using quite a bit for giving tours to people from all over the world to see the city in a brighter light. We've hosted potlucks and lots of camping type things, urban camping things in the city, including the biggest event we put out of here, which is the Trek Camp City. It's a weekend long event where we give tours. We use the bus as sort of a lounge that, you know, people can come in and they'll always be stationed at one location where they can ride their bike to it and hang out, find meeting people. And one of the main event we did for the last years, or 2 years ago, was to paint the bus, give up the money to me to paint the bus. And then we left a little mark on it. This is a cool paint job, but we wanted something a little bit more fitting of Camp Catawampus style, since it was going to be going to Lakes of Fire and also to the Elson Green. Since we were going to repaint it, we met up at Figment, heard about the Figment event on Belle Isle, put on by Doxy, and the Figment crew. And just opened it up and gave a bunch of paint cans to work with a local art studio called Square, where they supplied all the paint, and they got people involved, and they just kind of did whatever they wanted. And a lot of kids actually got involved and really enjoyed it. And it was going to be a one-day paint, so once they were done, we just went back over it and covered it with a nice coat of primer. A week later, I gave it a new paint job. This is the new face of Camp Catawampus. It was something that I wasn't sure I could do, but it always seems to be the case when you start something you don't need to do and you end up doing it. The first event I went to was the Alchemy Burn in Georgia. From there I went to, I think, Lakes of Fire one more time, and then various other events throughout Michigan. When he came back, we worked with a couple of arts communities where we used it as a shuttle between art events. There was a couple of monthly events where there's art pop or different galleries, so we kind of used it as a shuttle for those things. When he wasn't doing that, we actually did the night market event, where we turned it into a fortune teller's trailer, and we had various fortune teller things in there, like palm reading, Ouija board, a haunted telephone, and various things. And it was well attended, and it was really appreciated. We actually even got some offers to take this party to somebody else's, you know, someone else's party, which we weren't really set up for. Some of the other things that we've done with it that aren't pictured here are we use it as a community meeting space, a mobile movie theater, an art gallery, and a party bus. Right now it's sitting just waiting for the next big idea or a great adventure that any of you may have. If you have any ideas, come and let me know, and I'd be happy to talk about it.